What's up everybody and welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm gonna go over the three most common ways that thieves are stealing your car. Yes, if you have a C7 Z06, a Stingray, a Grand Sport, or a ZR1, your car is a hot commodity for the thieves right now. They're going for your LT4 motor. If you have the LT4 motor, they're going for your carbon fiber roof, they're going for your headlights, and they're going for your wheels and tires. Unfortunately, this is something that many of us are experiencing as of late, and they are doing this through key cloning, fob cloning, they are doing this through relay theft, and they are also doing this through tow trucks and flatbeds. So unfortunately, I have personal experience with this. I dealt with this, but I am one of the lucky ones that recovered my car. So I'm going to talk to you guys today about some products that I think would be really helpful on how to keep your car safe. And now if your car is stolen, some of these products are gonna help you find your car. But the number one thing that is important to understand is that you need to call the police. Do not go at it alone. Do not even risk bringing your friends into it. If somebody's got your car, call the police and let them know. It's a very, very dangerous thing. You're dealing with thugs, gangs, and cartels in a lot of these things. These are big theft rings, but time is very, very important. And the person who's stealing the car is most likely not the person who's chopping it up. So if you act quick and have the right equipment, there's a really good chance that you can recover your car. Now, a lot of people talk about having insurance. Well, insurance is nice, but unless you have a stated value policy, there's a good chance that the actual cash value of your car has dropped. So there's a good chance that if your car is stolen, you might not be able to replace it with something that is just like that. So maybe take a look at your insurance policy and have a stated value number that you are comfortable with, but it is very, very important. So let's dive right on in. So the first way that people are going to break into your car or steal your car is they are going to give your door a tug. Oh look, some people leave their car unlocked, very easy. They can get in and start messing with your car. But for those of you that lock your car, which is a smart thing, they're going to take a flathead screwdriver. They are going to pry in between the glass and the carbon fiber. They're going to mash it down. They're going to mash the glass down, and then they are going to put their tuner inside and take off the alarms. Boop, boop. They're in. Now that the thief is inside of your car, they're going to take their X431 or their programming scanning tool. They're going to sit here and they are going to find the code to the key. They're going to find the code to the ECU. They're going to disable OnStar. And then what they're going to do is they're going to get in the car. Okay, so the key programming and key cloning is most likely going to happen on the street or at an apartment complex. But what is also common is the second one, which is relay theft. Relay theft generally occurs when your car is parked outside of your house. I'm going to use a radio and an iPad to demonstrate this because I don't know what the heck those guys use, but this is also very common on how thieves are breaking into your car. They're gonna pull up. One of them is most likely going to drive the other car home, and the other one is going to drive the stolen car home. The guy number one is going to go up towards your house. He is going to be looking for the signal, the key signal, that your key is transmitting. Your key is always transmitting some sort of signal trying to find the car. And your car is also trying to receive the signal at the same time. So one guy is going to be up looking around your house, and the other guy is going to be holding a relay box trying to get the signal so he can get inside the car and trick the car into thinking that the key is with them. So the third and final way most people are getting away with stealing C7 Corvettes is they are taking a unmarked tow truck, and this is the one with the fork. They're going right up under it, they're lifting up, and they are gone. This is generally driven by a very, very skilled repo man or a tow truck driver looking to make some extra cash. This is, I would say, the most attention-getting way, but it is done the fastest. And a lot of these guys are very, very skilled at their job. So that is why it's time to dive on into some tech, as well as some techniques on security measures that you can put on your car in order to mitigate risk, maybe increase your recovery opportunity, but also it's just great security measures to have on your car. These keyless entry cars are very susceptible to theft, and it's about time it stops, because unfortunately there's not enough cops, there's not enough detectives to handle the thousands and thousands of cars that are stolen every single day. So I first wanted to talk about some low-tech preventative measures in order to help keep your car safe. The first one that I think is a smart recommendation is to have a license plate cover and bracket. This one that I have from WeatherTech actually has caps over the bolts, so it's going to take a whole lot more time for them to get that off. Another recommendation is if they're going to use a flathead or a Phillips head to go on ahead and break into your car, it would be wise to go on ahead and change your bolt pattern. You can use something like an Allen wrench or a T25, a unique bolt pattern that takes longer or is even so difficult that they are just going to have to give up. Now, your license plate is very important because it is an identifying number that cops can use or detectives can use with streetlight cameras as well as tollways. The other thing is when it comes to your garage door opener and your car keys, put those in a RFID box. Do not let that signal be transmitted and do not let others be able to receive that signal. So keep a RFID box inside your house for all of your keys, and then keep a RFID box inside of your car with your garage door opener. Another thing is if the OnStar module and the OnStar fuse can easily be taken out of the car, it would be wise to throw in some very, very inexpensive Apple AirTags. Hide two or three all over your car, but that is a great way to track your car for not a lot of money. So these are some low-tech preventative measures. So now that I've talked to you guys about some of the lower-tech methods, I also want to talk about some higher-tech methods. Now, a lot of these things are not super, super expensive, but it is a complicated process to install them. So I will leave all the links for you guys to check out a lot of these products. A lot of these products are going to want you to place an order at a local dealer and have them install it, which I recommend. I recommend that you let them do all the splitting the wires and hide all this stuff so it's not easily destroyed or visible if a thief tries to break into your car. So as far as theft security, I think a lot of people are either going to use the IGLA, which is a company that I think it's called Author Alarm. Basically, they have a PIN code, so that way you touch certain buttons on your steering wheel that basically are the kill switches for your engine as well as your fuel. So a two kill switch system is a pretty smart way to make sure that they don't even get to move the car. Another thing is a OBD diagnostic port blocker. This is a blocker that goes over your OBD port that stops them from messing with OnStar, messing with getting your ECU code, messing with your computers, and being able to duplicate keys. Another thing that has been mentioned in my exotic car group is a Ravelco anti-theft device. Their website seems a little bit more outdated, and a lot of the professionals are using IGLA as well as Compustar. Now, a full system that I really recommend, I think it's nice, and I think it probably does a really, really good job, is the Compustar XP9913AS. This is going to come with a Compustar T13 remote. It's also going to come with a First Tech shock and glass tilt sensor, as well as an engine relay. So somebody's too close to your car, they touch your glass, boom, the alarm's going off. If a tow truck tries to lift your car, boom, the alarm's going off. And that is also paired with tracking. So let's now talk about tracking. That is paired with a First Tech drone mobile X1 Max LTE. That's like having a separate cell phone in your car hidden away. And I think that does an amazing job because it lets you see where your car is going, lets you see where your car is moving, and it also allows you to shut the engine down. Now, unfortunately, I guess some people, maybe if their car has been stolen, it might be in the middle of the intersection, but the thief's not in it anymore. Now, another option for tracking is LoJack. LoJack is a technology that is used in coordination with police. So if you have LoJack installed, which is just like the drone mobile, it's a device hidden in your car that basically, whenever you call the police and let them know that your car has been stolen, it sends out a radio signal to all police cars around. And if a cop car comes within that area, it will pop up on their LoJack system that, hey, there's a stolen car nearby, and they're gonna know the information about that car. So LoJack is also a very, very nice tracking method. But I think a lot of these options you can combine together. Like I said, the prices are not real expensive, but I would definitely advise spending the money on a good shop that you trust to install all of this stuff. But I'm one of the lucky ones that got my Corvette back. I'm ready to put a lot of this great tech in it. That way nobody else ever even thinks about stealing it again. But as always, thank you guys for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you guys on the next video.